Oh man, I met Orlando when we were young enough to. He was always an individual that seemed to be older than his age, and if you know the legend of him, you kind of fail to realize that he died at the age of 21 or 22. That's how much impact he had made on our environment in that such a short period of time. But I met him at an age when he was young enough to not be even named Baby Lane, and I remember one of the most impressive things that I can remember of him, even prior to his gangster type lifestyle. He was talking about playing Pop Warner football and how when he goes to take his physical, he say, once he takes the physical, when they got a bomb, a bad looking nurse, a fine nurse in there, he used to ball up his paper and just to take the physical again so she could touch his dick and make him get hard. And we were so young, I was thinking he a fool for even thinking like that. But it just, the fact that he lived so much from that point on in such a young time, that was just a testament for me knowing this nigga was grown before the average nigga his age.
Yeah. We ain't gonna pump him up too much. You know, we don't like Baby Lane on this form.
Man, when you say we, you can't speak for us, you know?
I'm talking about the community.
The community don't really know. Like, they can't let politics affect reality. Like, you know, niggas got involved in politics and then the fans and the public. You can't take sides when politics dictated the activities, man. That shit wasn't personal for nobody. Not for Baby Lane, his side or the other side. You already know how we live out here. You should not fester a spirit of allowing the fans that are invested in the whole story to take sides on that level, my nigga. Baby Lane represent us more so than Tupac does. I'm sorry.
Yeah. I hear what I know where you're saying and going, but
I love Tupac in the spirit of everything that he represents in general. But when you, besides the personal fact that that was your friend and you ran with him, if you separate yourself from that and step in and then.
Well, all we did is 2+2. I tell them all the time that it was supposed to happen. What happened was me and you together, we would have got in a car and did what we had to do. You know what I'm saying?
Right. And that's why the last two teams in the Super Bowl were supposed to bring a hell of a game.
Exactly.
There's two teams that's suited up to go all the way. And it's like I've been involved in the same exact type of activity, and the politics was totally separated from that. And I know as an individual, no matter how many emotions that can't get involved, no matter how bad a war gets, I remember being in the middle of a deep war in my neighborhood and remember my big homie pulling up saying, oh yeah, I talked to so-and-so today. He said, it ain't really that big homie. It's they little homies that's with it. And it blew my mind for this nigga to say he was even having a friendly conversation with anybody from that side. That's how on it was at the time. And I was young. So when niggas start from the outside in on their keyboards, trying to look into this lifestyle and think they can make a judgment call, they fooling themselves already.
Yeah. Let's see, my boy Honest J, let me read what he said. Two brothers, he was just saying, So they kind of agreeing with you.
Yeah, it's like, you know, we can't really, like, you know, as much as you're going to hate your enemy, when you start asking me personally about the individuals involved, there's so much time passed.
Yeah. I respect what you were saying about
Baby Lane is a legend. Yeah. Look, I want your listeners to know Baby Lane is a legend with or without the Tupac interaction, bro.
In Compton.
Compton, in our culture.
In our culture.
He a nigga I'd be rapping about without, whether he had that engagement or not, I would be rapping about him. Him and Baby Draylon, rest in peace with Eastside Mob, Front Street Watts, my other brother. They like almost one of a kind. I got a lyric that actually states, called me crazy. Or maybe it's a baby thing. Baby Spider, Baby Draylon, Baby Lane. And when y'all really catch up to that and figure out of this whole L.A. County shit about Baby Crips, niggas that's named Baby. And if you want to name the top three, my nigga, I'm not trying to be cocky. I'll be very objective. When I stand back, take myself out the sequence. After you say Baby Draylon, Baby Lane, I'm trying to find throughout all L.A., Compton, Long Beach, what other baby can go in that trio. And it's only Baby Spider if anybody knows something about my streets out here. So I just thank God to be fortunate enough to be who I am, my nigga.
Yeah.